Bravo everyone, hi, hello, welcome back to my channel. So this video is all about North Macedonia. So the song has just been dropped on YouTube about 10 minutes ago. So of course, I think this was another song that got leaked earlier on, and of course I've not listened to the song, have no idea what it sounds like, but seems to be on Twitter at the moment a bit of mixed opinions about the song, so the usual. Vasil was meant to compete for North Macedonia last year, and obviously we all know what happened. So the North Macedonian broadcaster announced that, I think it was them, or I'm not sure if it was himself, but it was announced that he would be going for the nation again this year. So the song is called Here I Stand, which makes it sound very massive ballad, musical vibes. Just the title alone just gives me that kind of, vibe. So if it ends up like that, I won't be surprised in the slightest. So yeah, not gonna waste too much time. This is my take on their song.
This is very, very musical aria already. Building looks really pretty, I'll give you that. This feels like 90s. Interesting development with this first chorus. I mean, first verse. Vocally, it sounds impressive. And musically, I do like the orchestral sounds. It just feels like it should be in a film, or like a drama. Or even a musical. Or play, you know what I mean? Okay. Is this another one with gospel vibes? It's like choir vibes again. But okay, so yeah, I can imagine choir behind him. He's singing a song. I feel like you're acting out the part as well. I mean, it's vocally strong. Musically quite strong, but the song, I'm just a bit okay. Is this like a little, I wouldn't want to say a bridge, but it's almost like a very quiet solo bit before that big chorus comes in, or is this an outro? It's nice, I'll give you that. It's nice. Intro, pretty good outro. Okay, different, I'll give you that. Something we haven't heard in a while. I'll have another listen to it and then I'll get back to yous on that.
So I've gone through that a second time, and I think when you get to listen to it properly, you understand the song a lot more so than looking at it from the first get-go. And I really, really do get musical theatre vibes from this. It feels like a song that, if you took Eurovision out of the picture, this is something you'd kind of expect to see, like, if you've gone to, like, a play, for instance, and you've got Vasil there as maybe the protagonist, etc., and he's singing the aria, you know, almost like if it's an opera or some sort, but obviously it's not. But it almost gives a sense of very either musical theatre, but also classical, almost classical crossover vibes. I feel this is a song that definitely does showcase Vasil's singing abilities more so. It's more suited, I think. You know, that also thing where you could also see this song in a TV show, for instance. I don't know why I've been watching some international shows at the moment, and they always have music featured in them, like when something's gone on, and I can see it in those shows, and I don't know why, but I could see that happening. So I keep thinking back, actually, when I was watching it for the first time, I kept thinking, oh my god, this would fit so well in, like, you know, whatever show. And yeah, it just reminds me of that. In regards to Eurovision itself, we don't have a song like this. We do have gospel type vibes songs, as we know. We've got Austria, we've got Slovenia, we've got, there's at least another one, and I can't remember. I've gone through them, but I just don't remember. But there, gospel is a bit of a big theme this year, which I did not expect the slightest. But we don't have a song that necessarily has a gospel vibe that's very musical theatre. In fact, we don't really have a musical theatre song in there at all. So yes, it does stand out for that on that basis. Personally speaking, it's a song I kind of like. It's like, objectively speaking, it's a song that you probably shouldn't like, but it's a song I kind of like anyway, which is really weird, I guess. I mean, I think it all just comes down to taste. You're either not going to like the song and you think, oh my god, this is totally terrible, but you may also like the song and think, oh, actually, you know what, this is better than what people are coming out with. Maybe that's just me. Maybe that's just the sort of thing I gravitate towards. I don't know. I kind of like it, though. I'm not going to lie, it is dated, but then a lot of songs this year are. So that's not necessarily a criticism. I think, because there are mixed reviews, I think that it might be a case where it stands out, but it may not have enough impact to be able to resonate with maybe the public. I think the juries are going to be more so in terms of points for this one. What I'm saying is, where a lot of people at the moment seem to be writing it off as an easily non-qualifier, I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is, it could very well qualify and do better than people think. I don't know, that's just my take on it. Music video is very simple. It's obviously been recorded in this, they've set up a studio almost, I guess, in this building, which the building looks absolutely beautiful, by the way. Again, you know, being in a giant panini, simple probably is the best way forward at the moment. But the song is the song at the end of the day. It's more about the song than it is about the music video. But in terms of staging, I feel that it's going to be very simplistic, and it's obviously going to be focusing on Vasil more than anything. It's a ballad. It makes sense to focus on him. As a song, it's probably not the strongest there, but I like the song regardless, so I'm happy. But okay, that's just my take on it. You don't necessarily have to agree. So this is where you come into it. No puns intended. Feel free to drop in the comments what you think about the song. Do you think I'm giving it a bit too much credit for what it is? Do you think it may have a chance of reaching the final? And if so, where do you think it may finish? So, thank you for watching. Stay safe, and I'll see you soon. The People's Choice Awards are back for its second year running, sadly after last year's got cancelled. But this is where you get to vote for your favourite songs and artists from the Class of 2021 in a number of categories, including Best Song, Best Artist, Best Group, and much more. The link to vote is in the comments section, and voting is open until the 2nd of May, so you've got a long time to vote, and the results will be announced in a video the week later. All the details needed are in the comments section as well. Thank you for watching.